name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and living God, whose Son was pleased to be welcomed in St. Martha's house as a guest, grant, we pray, that through her intercession, serving Christ faithfully in our brothers and sisters, we may merit to be received by you in the halls of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we may have life through him. And this is love, not that we have loved God, but that God has loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain within him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that God sent his Son, that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. I will bless the Lord at all times.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear and be glad.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
I will bless the Lord.
Look to him, that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Bless the man who takes refuge in him.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Fear the Lord, you his holy ones, for naught is lacking in those who fear him. The great will grow poor and hungry, but those who seek the Lord want for no good thing.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Alleluia.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother, Lazarus, who had died. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And anyone who lives and believes in me will never die." "Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
With one heart, let us offer our prayers to the Lord. For the Church, the body of Christ, may the Lord in his mercy increase us in holiness and charity. We pray to the Lord.
Our Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace and flourishing of all nations of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Our Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, may God's healing touch bring them comfort and relief. We pray to the Lord.
Our Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who will pray in faith, may the compassion of the Lord be upon us in all we do. We pray to the Lord.
Our Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, through the mercy of God, may they rest in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Our Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions we hold deeply in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear the prayers in which we have presented here before you. May they be answered in due time according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, so will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice and charity for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his nation.
As we proclaim your wonders in St. Martha, O Lord, we humbly implore your majesty that as her homage of love was pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the saints who have consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise, the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints,
as we praise you without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one. You may be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," live not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those who are not able to receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer a prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, I'm at least spiritually in my heart. I wish you as if you were already there and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. May the holy reception of the body and blood of your only begotten Son, O Lord, turn us away from the cares of this fallen world, so that following the example of St. Martha, we may grow in sincere love for you on earth and rejoice to behold you for eternity in heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.